McGuire sisters? Ain't y'all got anything livelier than this?
Liveliest place in town's a graveyard, Stella.
Well, hell, Sissy, for you it always was.
Don't.
Come on, what do you say?
No, you and Edna Louise go on. I'm trying to get this place to look like something.
Come on, Edna. Christ, it is so damn hot in here. Now listen, Lynn, listen, don't say nothing to Mona about us being here, see, because I want to surprise her.
God, this is going to be a hoot, goddamn hoot and a half.
Come on, Edna.
Well, I'll have to change my dress.
Later, you can do it later. I want to get on out there, see if I really miss this town or not. Hey, hey, see, listen, we'll stop on over to old Luigi's Taco Grotto, get ourselves a Dr. Pepper like we used to.
Mona's going to be real pleased and surprised to see him again.
You think anybody else going to be showing up for this thing?
Well, her heart's dead set on them all showing up, but we're just going to have to wait and see, I guess.
Sissy, have you heard the news? It's absolutely breathtaking.
Hey, y'all agreed. I could feel it.
Tell us what, Delma.
Elizabeth Taylor and Rock Hudson are going to be coming here.
Stop!
Wait a minute. Here to Picard, the Texas.
Well, not exactly here, but over to Marfa. It's only 62 miles away from Christ.
Wait, no. What are they coming here for?
They're coming to make a movie.
You hush up, Edna Louise. I'm telling, not you. They're coming to make a picture show, and the radio said it's all about giants or something.
A monster movie!
Anything like the creature from the Black Lagoon? That picture scared me.
I know. Hey, Louise, you'd be so damn dumb, would you?
Mona, Mona, you're just going to fall on over dead when you hear who else is coming to be in it, too.
Tab Hunter!
No. Well, goddamn it, Stella May, who is it?
Sandy!
Damn it, all the hell ain't
enough! Help it, his name is still out of my mouth. Thinking?
You're never thinking. We all agreed I could tell him, and you just ruined everything. Look, I don't know why you let her hang around us anyhow. She's younger than we are. She's just so damn dumb.
The red. Tell them the red.
There's more, y'all.
The radio says they're going to be looking for people to be in that picture, too.
Imagine being in a picture show with James.
Lester T tonight.
Oh, shit.
Why does this always happen to me?
How do you suppose we'll get on over there?
Just ask to borrow your mom's Buick.
I told you that she's not going to let me borrow that car.
Well, tell her that you're going on over there to hunt for a better job.
And she's never going to believe that.
You just lie to her, Joe. That's all you have to lie to her.
Juanita, what do you think of these decorations?
Real nice.
Well, I have busted my butt all morning getting them strung up here, you know. All right, I'm going to Luke's and I'll be right back. Now, what'd you want? You want Miracle Whip and bologna and cheese and just...
No, bread.
All right. Hey, Juanita! Her bus is pulling up now.
That darn fool, a bus broke down out there, broke down in the middle of nowhere. It took them nearly forever to get it repaired. Well, you do look like something the cat may have dragged in.
Thank you, Juanita.
Here's an orange brush. Why don't you go over there and sit down?
Are you as excited and nervous as I am? I could hardly contain myself that whole weekend long in Marfa just thinking about it. 20 years ago tonight, my God, it just seems just like yesterday, don't it? When that fatal crash took away his life.
Aha!
Juanita, do you think that it's possible that you could stop that slapping around for just 5 seconds? Thank you. What's that? What's that? Is this what I think it is?
Oh,
my goodness sake, look at this one. It's the old club jacket. Where on earth did you dig this up from?
Well, Stella May brought it in.
Stella May?
Oh, my goodness. I just let the cat right on out of the bag.
Well, is Stella May here then? Stella May? My goodness sake, Stella May? Stella May?
Have any of the others come?
Stella Mae. Oh, and Edna Louise.
Edna Louise come too.
Don't you let on like I told you, though, because they wanted to surprise you.
Well, I promise one lady yet. I was really worried that they might not all remember. Oh. I really should have sent them all them little tiny, what do you call them, little card thing, little reminder cards, don't you think?
Lord, how would you ever know where to find half of them?
No, they did scatter off every which way and another first chance that they got, didn't they? I remember the day that we took this picture, and I recall it just like it was yesterday. Stella Mae, she's sticking out her tongue and she's making that awful silly face, I swear. She never could be serious. Sue Ellen had them curler things in her hair and she tried to hide behind Martha. That was the very last time that the entire club was all together as one. Certainly hope that we will all be able to recognize each other. Wouldn't that be an awful thing? I'm sure that they will all remember. How could they possibly have forgotten such a devoted promise as that one was? Oh.
You all right?
It's my heart. Just tends to skip a beat every now and then, that's all. It's all this dry air. It's just affecting my asthma. Something terrible. You know, I've been wheezing and struggling to keep a breath all day long.
Well, set yourself down. I'll freshen up your orange.
No, Juanita, no. I can't sit. Lord, I don't think I'll be able to sit.
Juanita! It may sound silly.
Juanita!
Already. Well, we all just waved you off to that college not more than a week ago.
I know you did, but I don't have to go after all. Isn't that wonderful?
You don't have to go?
No, ma'am, I don't.
Well, what in heaven's name went wrong?
Wrong? Nothing went wrong. It was my asthma. It got worse. It really did. The climate there, it's just not right for my asthma. The doctor said so.
The doctor? You mean they had to send for the doctor?
Oh, Juanita, it was a terrible thing. It was just terrible. You know what happened? I was standing in line, and I was waiting to sign in for my classes, and I just collapsed. I collapsed into a dead heap right under the floor.
I'll get you an orange crush.
Thank you. It was real scary to everybody. They told me afterwards that they thought that I was dead. I thought I might have died myself for a minute. All at once, I felt me a premonition that death had come to take me away. Just like the one that they say that James Dean has all the time. But then when I came to, then I knew that James Dean could never possibly die. And so I lived too. Sydney will give me my job back, won't he?
I'm sure he will.
Oh, good.
We're sure to help.
Isn't it lucky, too? Isn't it lucky that it happened just in time to allow me to return for tonight's meeting of the disciples? I was really worried on how the club would ever continue without my leadership. Juanita, you know something? I missed you. I missed you a whole lot. Of course, Sissy and Joe. I can't wait to see their faces when they hear I'm back home for good.
They're across the way over at Mona Honey.
Yes, ma'am.
Joe's not working.
Oh, you mean he's not working today? Well, that's wonderful, then, because we could spend the whole afternoon together. If you don't care, Juanita, you know what we'll do, though? We'll come by around 5:30, and then we could help you close up. All right, bye-bye. See you later, Juanita. My throat is as parched as that poor ground out there. Oh, if you think that it is hot here, my goodness sake, then you should have been in Marfa. That first day there, I thought, well, now, here it comes. My goodness sake, I'm going to die for sure.
Were the things just like you was hoping they'd be?